welcome to this memorial service to celebrate the lives of our Green Hills friends and neighbors that died this past year from May 1, 2019 to May 1, 2020. We miss them during this time of remembrance, and we want to celebrate who they were and what they meant to us. As we light this welcome candle, recalling that those we remember today brought light to our lives, and the flame of their candles guided the paths of many others, known and unknown.
Crossed the bar. As we reflect upon Memorial Day, we find ourselves in unique circumstances. The presence of the COVID-19 virus creates a time when we are not able to gather, perhaps not as easily visit the cemetery where a memorial service might be held. However, we can still recognize family, friends, as well as those who have served their country. As a relatively new resident of Green Hills, I was asked to make a few remarks. I want to reflect not only on the importance of this day in paying respect and remembering individuals who gave their lives in service to our country, not only the 1.1 million men and women who have died in wartime throughout our nation's history, but the healthcare, first responders, frontline workers, including those at Green Hills who have made it possible for most of us to maintain social distance and relative isolation over the past several weeks. In addition to the 25 Green Hills residents who passed away during the past year, there are thousands of individuals who have died from the virus over the past several weeks. Unfortunately, the numbers are expected to continue to grow in the coming days. This should truly humble all of us, as they represent people, individuals who are husbands, wives, mothers, sisters, brothers, friends. Just like the 25 Green Hills residents who passed away this past year, they were people woven into the fabric of the communities of which they were a part of across the nation. They were loved, they were mourned, and they will be missed. Although a relatively new Green Hills resident, over the years I've had the opportunity to know and would work with many of the individuals who have passed away, but they had the vision to create and then become part of the Green Hills community. Memorial Day is a time to recognize those who have recently passed away and to reflect upon those who have contributed to our past. Green Hills is special because of its people, the sense of place, commitment, and contributions our residents made to the world in which we live. For most of us, the past few weeks have upended our normal routines, imposing social isolation for much of our day-to-day activity. The virus has impacted millions of people and their families around the world. The loss of life here in the United States exceeds the deaths of many of our major military conflicts. Those losses leave holes in the families and communities in which all of those people were a part. We will continue to be challenged during the coming months. We are fortunate to be part of a caring and compassionate community supported by an excellent staff. On this Memorial Day, as we pause and give thanks and recognition, particularly to those who have passed away in the past year, we can all breathe a prayer of thankfulness to have known them and benefited from their guidance. Memorial Day is also a chance to reflect and reconnect to our past. I hope that you will reflect, at least for a moment today, on those whose lives have been special to each of us.
Following are the list of names. Ronald Peters. Edward Hamilton. Mary Jean Reimers. Mary Atherley. Barbara Bobby Warman. Mary Wicks. Melvin Larson. Janice Burkhart. Joy Munn. Elmer Clayton. Beverly Van Fossen. Jeff Berger. Patricia A. Thompson. Philip Lehman. Randall Cutler. Elizabeth Howell. Margaret Ewing. Catherine Mason. Albert Gene Freeman. Donald Payer. James Ling. Frank Rizzo. Ruth David. Warney John Johnson.